Hello and welcome guys to this class which is on practical aspects of anesthesia for third MBBS students. So all the final year MBBS students who are going for your exams next month, this class is especially for you guys. This is going to cover all the instruments, not just in anesthesia, but also there are some instruments which are asked in your medicine table viva as well. Okay, so this is a table viva based class, and here I'm going to be showing you each and every instrument and how to describe it in your exam. So I hope you guys can see me and hear me well. Please make sure that you write on the chat box that you're able to see me and hear me well. Only then will I be able to interact with you guys. Okay. All right. So let's begin with our class. Before we begin, I would like to introduce you to the Unacademy platform. It is India's largest learning platform, and you can get an amazing subscription on this platform called as the Iconic subscription. Here you will get the best of all the live classes of Unacademy along with the videos of Prep Ladder, which is one of the premium places for learning about your NEET PG. We also have many free things coming up for you guys. There is a daily free test series on the Unacademy NEET PG channel, where you have 20 questions which have to be solved in 20 minutes. This you can all get it just by downloading the Unacademy app onto your phones. This is a little bit about the plus subscriptions and their pricing plans. So you can see that a 1 month plus subscription will cost you nothing but 4,500 rupees. That is probably the amount of money that you'll spend on your Valentine's Day date tomorrow. So I think instead of giving your date a gift, you should give her an Unacademy plus subscription so that both of you can get an amazing rank in NEET PG. Okay, so I'm unable to see chat messages from you guys. I need you to be interactive in this class. We are starting off with three courses for FMG as well as for NEET PG batch. So please do have a look at the courses, and let's start with our class for today. Please make sure that you answer in the class, because that will help you to boost your confidence for the exam. Okay, so the first thing that we are going to be talking about is this. Can anyone tell me what is this called? Can you write on the chat box? Can anyone tell me what is this called? Okay, so this is called as an anesthesia face mask. Okay, or simply it is called as a face mask. So I'm going to write it down for you guys over here. So whenever we are going to pick up anything on the table viva, okay, first thing we'll do is we'll identify what it is. So first identification mein you will say that it is a face mask. The second thing that you will need to do is description. Okay, so how are we going to describe this face mask? We are going to say that this is a transparent face mask. It is made up of medical grade silicone. Okay, it can also be made up of other materials like rubber, and it can come in different colors, especially in the black color. Okay, the most commonly used face mask is a transparent face mask. Now can anyone tell me why am I stressing on the transparent face mask? Anyone? Okay, so we are stressing on the transparent part of the face mask because when you hold it onto a patient to ventilate him, if there are any vomitus or secretions or blood that are coming out of the face of the patient, you will be able to see it through the transparent part of the face mask. Okay, if you're not able to see it, then the patient may aspirate whatever secretions he has. So it's very important that you guys see it and you suction it out whenever you see blood, secretions or vomitus. Okay, now what are the parts of this face mask? So you have a hub where you will attach the face mask, okay, to the circuit. Now how to attach this to the circuit, again I'll show you in this class. And then this is called as the body of the face mask. So that is how you'll describe it, and this is called as the rim of the face mask. Okay, so the rim of the face mask, this is the other side of the face mask which goes onto the patient's face, and you can see that this rim is given so that it forms a good seal with the patient's face. Okay, now this face mask comes in different sizes depending on whether you have a pediatric patient or whether you have an adult patient. this conical shaped one will fit well on your nose as well as oral cavity, okay, like this. You also get one which is circular in shape, so you'll also get a circular shaped face mask, and that is specially used in pediatric patients, okay. This is called as an anatomical face mask. Why are we calling it as a anatomical face mask? Because it exactly fits on the anatomy, on the nasal as well as the oral anatomy, and that one is called as a circular face mask, okay. Now the part 3, after description of whatever you have, what is the part 3? You have to explain the uses. So what is the use of this face mask? Can anyone tell me any one use of the face mask? Just tell me one use of the face mask that you guys know of. I'm looking at your answers in my phone. I can see the chat. Anyone, what is the use of the face mask? Okay, the face mask is used for ventilation. When do you ventilate the patient? You ventilate the patient under anesthesia, so when a patient is undergoing surgery, okay, and you ventilate a patient who is sedated, so if you have given sedation, or to ventilate an unconscious patient. Or the other time that you can use this face mask is for CPCR. Okay, CPCR, when you're trying to resuscitate a patient, you will use a face mask as an ambu bag and resuscitate the patient. Okay, so this is our first instrument for today, and that is a face mask. Now, let's move on to the next instrument that we have. And can anyone identify this for me? This is how it comes in a packet. And this is how it looks like. Can anyone identify this for me? Guys, please make sure that you answer in the chat box. This has to be an interactive session. Okay, so this is called as an endotracheal tube. Okay, you can see it in the picture also. It looks exactly like how it is in the picture. Now, what are the parts of this endotracheal tube? So, as I told you, like the previous one, first you have to identify what this is exactly, okay? So, this is an endotracheal tube. The next thing that we'll do is the description of this tube, okay? So, how do you describe this tube? So, we'll say that this tube is made up of PVC, okay? This is a transparent tube which is made up of polyvinyl chloride. That is the material it is made up of. Now, you get many different types of tubes which are made of different materials, but this is the one which is classically used everywhere. So, this is what will be asked in your exam, okay? Now, it is made up of PVC. Then you can see that what are the parts of the tube. So here we have the universal connector. What do you mean by the universal connector? So this is a 15 mm adapter, okay. The size of this adapter is 15 millimeters, and this connects to the ambu bag, it connects to any kind of circuit, it connects to catheter mounts. So it is a universal connector, okay. So you can connect it to any ventilating device. After that, you will see this is the body of the endotracheal tube, and this is the end of the endotracheal tube, okay. Now, the specific thing that we need to discuss about this is the end of the endotracheal tube. So, can you guys see over here that here you have a beveled end? I'll just show you closely. You can see it against the back black background of my t-shirt. So, can you see the beveled end? Yes, you can see the beveled end over here. Okay, of the endotracheal tube. And then on the other side, we have a hole over here. Can you see the hole? I'll just put the pencil through the hole. Okay, so in the endotracheal tube at the other end, can you tell me what is the name of this hole? So you can see this is the beveled end on one side, and this is the hole on the other side. So what is this hole called? Yes. That hole is called as Murphy's eye, okay? So it is called as Murphy's eye. Now, what is the function of Murphy's eye? So whenever this distal end of the tube, or whenever the bevel gets blocked, suppose you have intubated the patient and put the tube inside his airway, and the tube gets blocked due to secretions or a clot, okay? So this extra hole on the side, this extra hole on the side will act as a side ventilating port, okay? So it will act as another conduit for ventilation or a side ventilating port. So that is the use of the Murphy's eye. This is typically what they ask you in the exam. Okay, the next thing that they will ask you is about this thing that you can see over here. This is nothing but a cuff. Okay, so why do you need a cuff? A cuff helps in better fitting of the endotracheal tube in the trachea. Okay, so if this is your trachea over here and I'm putting in my endotracheal tube, now this, there is all this space around which is empty, right? So how do you fill up this space? You fill up this space by inflating the cuff of the endotracheal tube. Okay, so how do we inflate the cuff of the endotracheal tube? Let me show you. So I take a syringe, I take about 5 cc of air in it, and this is the pilot inflation line and the pilot balloon which fills the cuff. Okay, so first what I do is I completely deflate this cuff. Just have a look at it. I'm aspirating the air out and the cuff is getting deflated. Okay, after that I fill little bit of air. So as I fill air in this, you can see that the cuff is getting inflated. Okay, so you can see that the cuff is getting inflated. Typically it requires just 3 to 5 mL of air to inflate this cuff. Okay, and whenever you're removing the endotracheal tube out of the patient's airway, you should make sure that you deflate this cuff. So you should deflate the cuff. Okay, all right. Now another thing that you need to see in describe in this endotracheal tube over here is the black line. Okay, so there is a radio opaque, there are two black lines. The first one that you need to know is this one, a horizontal black line. So this horizontal black line will give you an idea about the position of the endotracheal tube. Okay, so when you do a laryngoscopy and you introduce the tube into the trachea of the patient, then how deep do you need to go? So you need to go just beyond the cords. Okay, so this black line that we are talking about, the horizontal black line, okay, has to be just beyond the cords. So this much part is in your larynx. This much part of the tube is in your larynx and this horizontal line is just beyond your cords. Okay, after that there is another vertical black line that you see. So I don't know if you guys can see it over here. It's a very thin radio opaque black line over here. Okay, so this, the which goes along the entire length of the endotracheal tube, this radio opaque black line helps in seeing the position of the endotracheal tube in the x-ray. Okay, so if you want to confirm the placement of the endotracheal tube in the trachea on an x-ray, then you will just be able to see that radio opaque black line which will indicate the tube. Okay, and last but not the least, what you will see over here are these markings of 28 cm, 26 cm, 24 cm, 22 cm. Okay, so these give the distance from the tip. Okay, so this, as the tube comes out, this part will be somewhere between the teeth of the patient. So you will say that it is 22 centimeter away from the tip. It is 20 centimeter away from the tip. Okay, so that is how you know how deep you have to go in the particular patient to make sure that the endotracheal tube is at the right place. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you guys. Now the next thing that we will be discussing is another type of endotracheal tube. This is called as the armored tube. Okay, so I'll just show you guys the armored tube. This is how it looks like. This is what packet it comes in, and this is also called as the flexometallic tube. So I'll write it down for you guys. It is also called as the flexometallic tube. Okay, before that, I'm so sorry, we had to discuss the uses of the endotracheal tube over here. So the uses is again for mechanical ventilation, okay, for anesthesia and to protect from aspiration. Okay, so I'm writing it over here, aspiration protection. Alright, so these are all our uses of the endotracheal tube. Now next, flexometallic tube. It is similar to the endotracheal tube that we just saw, but that is made up of polyvinyl chloride, and this one is a little different. Okay. So this one, as you can see, again similar things. It has a calf, it has a bevel, it has a Murphy's eye. Murphy's eye is very clearly seen over here. This is the Murphy's eye and this is the bevel end. Okay, this is the bevel end and this is the Murphy's eye and a calf. And you can see over here that there is a black line and the same markings that you had seen in the Potex tube. Okay, but as you can see over here, when I kink this tube, or when I knot this tube, or when I bend this tube, the cavity inside remains patent. And why does the cavity remain patent? You can see that there are metallic wirings inside it, and those metallic wirings help in keeping the cavity patent. Okay, so these are specifically used for head and neck surgeries, where you're sharing this area with the surgeon. So you're sharing the airway area with the surgeon. So this is the use for this flexometallic tube or armored tubes in head and neck surgeries, thyroid surgeries. Okay, this is where we use this flexometallic tube. Now next thing over here, can anyone identify this? This is a very easy thing to identify. So this is your laryngoscope. Okay, now this is your Macintosh laryngoscope. Okay, I don't see any doubts from you guys. So if you have any doubts, or if you want me to repeat anything, please let me know in the chat box. Okay, now this is your laryngoscope. What are the parts of, how will you describe this? You will say that, madam, this is a laryngoscope. This is a curved blade laryngoscope. You can see that this blade is curved. So this is called as a Macintosh laryngoscope. Okay, there is also another famous one which I'll show you now later. Now what are the parts of this laryngoscope? So we remove this from here. You can see that this is the handle of the laryngoscope. So this is where you hold the laryngoscope, and this is the blade of the laryngoscope. Okay, now this handle of the laryngoscope, what does it have? It contains, when you open it from down, you will see that it contains batteries. Okay, so it has a battery inside to light up the laryngoscope. Okay, then in this blade of the laryngoscope, this horizontal part, that is called as the flange of the laryngoscope. Okay, now this flange of the laryngoscope is used for pushing the tongue to one side. Then over here you can see the torch of the laryngoscope. Okay, and finally, how do you connect the laryngoscope? You take this, push it here, and push it with the thumb, and you can hear a click. Okay, now how do you use a laryngoscope? Just open this up and you will see that there is a light coming up from the laryngoscope. Okay, so how do you use a laryngoscope? We hold it always in the left hand, irrespective of whether you're a left-handed person or a right-handed person. You insert it in the right side of the mouth and you sweep the tongue to the left. Okay, so you insert it in the right side of the mouth and sweep the tongue to the left, and then lift the laryngoscope from the handle. Okay, so when you lift the laryngoscope, here your epiglottis will be there and it will get lifted up, and down you will see the vocal cords, which are seen very clearly because of the light coming from here. Okay, so this is your laryngoscope. What is the material that it is made up of? It is made up of stainless steel. Okay, now I have another type of laryngoscope which they ask commonly in your exam. I have only the blade over here, but can you guys identify what is this laryngoscope? Anyone? So there would be a handle like this attached over here. I'm just attaching a syringe just to hold. Okay, but can anyone identify this laryngoscope for me? It is a straight blade laryngoscope. As you can see, it's different from this. This one is a curved blade laryngoscope. This one is a straight blade laryngoscope. So any idea? Okay, so this is called as Miller's laryngoscope. Okay, so we saw Macintosh, which was the curved blade laryngoscope. Now this one is Miller's. which is a straight blade laryngoscope. Okay, now this one is used in pediatric patients for intubation. That is what you need to remember. Okay, uses of the laryngoscope. The main use of the laryngoscope is for intubation. Okay, what are the other uses of laryngoscope? It can also help in Ryle's tube insertion. Sorry, it's going behind my head, whatever I'm writing. Okay, so it can also help in Ryle's tube insertion. So you just do a pharyngoscopy in that case. Okay, just clear the tongue from the oral cavity and just direct the Ryle's tube with the megills. Okay, so this helps also in inserting your Ryle's tube when it's not going easily. And the other thing that you can use it for, other than Ryle's tube insertion, is for suctioning under guidance and throat pack insertion. Okay, sometimes we insert a big wad of cotton ball inside, that is called as a throat pack, and that is for absorbing all the secretions and blood, especially in head neck surgeries. All the secretions and blood will go down and it can irritate the larynx when the patient is awake and cause laryngospasm. Okay, so that's why we put that throat pack, so that it absorbs all those secretions and blood, and then later at the end of surgery you can remove it. Okay, now the next thing that we need to discuss, this one is specific to anesthesia. This is the LMA. Okay, so can anyone tell me which type of LMA is this? Okay, Praveen is asking, in children we will give spinal anesthesia at L4, L5 level. Now it depends on what children are you asking. In very small children we give caudal anesthesia, which is actually at the level of the sacral hiatus. Okay, so that is even below the lumbar spine, that is caudal anesthesia. If you're talking about in between adolescents or maybe children between 4 to 10 years of age, we give spinal anesthesia usually in L3, L4 or L4, L5 space. Any of it is okay. Okay, alright. So anyone, what is this? Which LMA is this? First of all, it is a laryngeal mask airway that all of us know. Okay, this is, it comes in this dabba. This is exactly the LMA that is there in the picture. Okay, so this is called as an eye gel LMA. Okay, this is an eye gel LMA. What are the different types of LMA that will come in your exam? So I'll just write it over here for you guys. This is a ProSeal LMA. This is a Classic LMA. And this is an LMA Supreme. Okay. So these are all the different types of LMAs that will be asked in your exam. Now if we look at this one, eye gel LMA. Okay. Now they'll ask you what are the parts. So again, this is the connector of the LMA. After that, inside, it may not be very obvious to you over here, but actually there are two openings. Okay, this one over here connects to the airway tube, which is used for ventilation, and then on the side over here you can see there is another opening that is a gastric tube. Okay, so here in the gastric tube, what we do is we put a Ryle's tube. Okay, so I have a Ryle's tube over here. I'll attempt to put it. Actually, we need a lot of jelly for inserting it. This is a Ryle's tube. You guys must have seen it in your ward rounds. Okay, we'll be discussing this also. So this is a Ryle's tube, and what you ideally do is, hello Free Fire Pro, he wanted me to take his name. So we, through the gastric tube, here you will connect the ventilator, and through the gastric port we'll put this Ryle's tube inside. Okay, and at the end of the surgery, so ideally if this whole thing goes inside, it will come out from this end. Okay, and what you do is at the end of surgery you will suction out whatever secretions are there from this end of the Ryle's tube. Okay, so what is this gastric port used for? It is used for suctioning out whatever secretions are there in the esophagus of the patient. Okay, this airway tube is used for ventilating the patient. Now here you will see that the size of the LMA is written. So this is a size 5 LMA, below that they have written it is recommended for what? Weight. Okay, so it is recommended for people from 90+ kg. Okay, so anyone who is 90+ kg should be put an LMA of size 5. Okay, below that they have written what is the type of LMA. So this is an eye gel LMA. This is called as the cuff of the LMA. Okay, this is the cuff of the LMA. This is what helps in ventilating the patient. Now usually, just like the endotracheal tube, if you see, in the endotracheal tube you can see that there is a pilot inflation line, pilot balloon and a cuff. Okay, similarly in an LMA, to inflate this cuff also we have a pilot inflation line and a pilot balloon. But this is a cuffless LMA. Okay, iGel is a cuffless LMA. What it does is that it takes the heat from your body and it expands and it forms a good seal with your larynx. Okay, so here in iGel LMA we don't need a cuff. If you see in the other LMAs, here you can see there is a pilot balloon. In the ProSeal LMA there is a pilot balloon, in the Classic LMA and there is a pilot balloon in the Supreme LMA. So here you have those LMAs where you can inflate the cuff using air by attaching it to the pilot balloon. Okay, so Praveen is asking general anesthesia pregnancy effect karta hai. For that you will have to see my 4-hour class on obstetric anesthesia on the Unacademy platform. Okay, that is nothing that can be answered in just one sentence. So this was about our iGel LMA. Okay, now after this what do we have next over here? Can anyone identify what is this if they give you in the exam? So I'll show you in real life what it is. You can see this. Okay, so this is nothing but a first, as I told you, hamesha first you have to name the thing. Okay, so this is a thermovent HEPA filter. Okay, this is a thermovent HEPA filter. Now what it is also called as an HME filter. So what is the full form of HME? The full form of HME is heat and moisture exchanger. Now what does this do? This is used whenever you ventilate a patient. Okay, so let me show you the next thing also. This is called as a catheter mount. So what we do is connect this HME filter to the catheter mount, and then this end of the catheter mount will go into the mask. Okay, so here this is how it will connect. Now this will be over here. This part will get connected to your circuit which is coming from the ventilator. Okay, so like this. So this is how you ventilate a patient. Okay, now what is the use of this heat and moisture exchanger? I'll tell you. Whenever you expire breath, okay, so your expired breath will have heat and moisture in it. So what happens is there are microfibers inside this. You can see the white colored part, and the heat and the moisture will get trapped in these microfibers. Now when the cold air comes from the ventilator, it will pass from the other end. It will pass from this end, it will go through this part, it will take that heat and moisture and go into the patient's airway. So you don't give dry and cold gases to the patient, you give him moistened and warm gases. Okay, so that is how a heat and moisture exchanger works. Now next thing, this is called as a catheter mount, as I told you. Okay, so what is the use of a catheter mount? Catheter mount is used for connecting to the circuit. Okay, now your circuit, if you directly connect it to the face mask, what will happen is it is big, it is bulky and it can fall easily, it can disconnect all the time. So that is why what you do is you use this in between thing which is called as the catheter mount and the filter which we attach, so that this is very light, it is very flexible, so your circuit will not keep disconnecting and falling off from this. Okay, so these are all our instruments. I'm quickly going to show you. I also have a part 2 tomorrow, so there we are going to be discussing many other instruments, your central line, your Ryle's tube, your Freca tube or your nasojejunal tube, then your epidural catheter, your spinal needle, all of that also. Okay, so quickly I'm just going to show you all the instruments one after the other. So this one over here that we saw first was the face mask, okay? After that, what we have is the endotracheal tube. So the endotracheal tube is here, okay? So this is our endotracheal tube. After that, the next thing that we have is the armored tube, which I had shown you, which is the flexometallic tube, okay? After that, the next one we have is the laryngoscope, okay? So this is the Macintosh laryngoscope, the curved blade laryngoscope. After that, we have the Miller's laryngoscope, which is the straight blade laryngoscope, okay? Then we have the LMA over here, okay? So this was our LMA, IGEL LMA. So this was our IGEL LMA over here. Okay, then we have the catheter mount followed by the filter followed by the catheter mount. Okay, so these are all the things that you need to know about, and then the rest we'll discuss in tomorrow's class. So thank you for joining me today, guys. I had a wonderful time with you. But tomorrow again, we have a lot of classes lined up. So make sure that you're attending them. Okay. My Unacademy referral code is Dr. Janvi YT. And by using this code, you can get a 10% off on your Unacademy subscription. So thank you for joining me today, and I will see you tomorrow at the same time. 9